Hello, Malty Malt Bears. Ralphie here, Whisky Review 303. And a big shout out to Andrew in Australia for that malt mention. And we've got a malt here, and we're going to mention it. And it's unusual, it's interesting, and I hope it inspires you by the end of this vlog to do your own thing. You see, about a year ago, in September 2011, I was at Whisky Review 178, where I reviewed this Springbank 10-year-old single malt. 179, I reviewed this Long Row 10-year-old single malt. And for Whisky Review 180, I reviewed this Hazelburn 12-year-old. Now, all three come from the one distillery in Campbellton, in the west coast of Scotland. It's a small craft distillery. It doesn't add spirit caramel to give that additional brown colouring to help make you believe that the whisky must be better. No, they don't do that, and they don't chill filter either. And they bottle their whiskies, their single malts, at 46% volume, because when you get a bit more alcohol, you get a bit more flavour. It's as simple as that. And the chill filtration, well, as you know by now, because most of you have been following these Ralphie vlogs, you know that chill filtration strips out the proteins and the vegetal oils that come through in the spirit from the still, and it basically adds texture and substance to the existing flavour of the whisky. And when it's removed, sure, you can add ice cubes in your whisky won't go slightly cloudy, but frankly, I don't think anybody out there really cares about that. I just don't think so. That's my opinion. Reasonable reviews, but once I'd finished them, of course, I had quite a bit of whisky left. And after an evening or two with friends, sharing a few drams, well, I noticed that I had exactly a third of the bottle of this one, a third of the bottle of this one, and a third of the bottle of this one. And I thought to myself, well, what would it be like if I mixed the three of them together into a bottle and left it to bottle mature for about a year and then reviewed it? And that's exactly what I've done. Here it is. Bankrowburn, the combination of Springbank, Long Row, and Hazelburn. It remains a single malt, despite being three different whiskies, for the simple reason that all three have come from the same distillery. It is unchill filtered. It doesn't have any brown dye added to it. It's been bottled at 46% volume for the simple reason these three have. Before I committed myself to this experiment, I did generate a small sample to be on the safe side, because some blendings can be a disaster, and it's a shame to waste good whiskey on bad experiments. So before you blend anything, try a drop in a glass, see if it works. Put some in a miniature bottle or some similar vessel. Leave it for about a week or a month for it to marry in, then taste it. And then you can commit yourself to the whole thing. I'll give you the tasting notes first. You know, of course, that you can't buy this, but you also know that you can make it for yourself. Sharp, fragrant, aromatic wood. Cocoa malt, touch of chocolate. Some citrus wood. Peat, hint of peat, more than a hint of peat actually, lemon rind, almond, some nuttiness, hints of hazelnut as well. Almond and hazelnut. Cinnamon, menthol, very mild, creamy menthol. Vanilla and avocado, so there's a wee green vegetal note in here. Taste-wise, and I'm going to add some water because it is, after all, been bottled at 46%. The water reduces the strength of the alcohol and it helps to release the flavours that are locked up in the alcohol. Taste. Sharp attack. It's a sharp arrival, dominated by the long row side of things. Although I'm having a guess there because it's been a year marrying together, so you can't really be too specific about what's done what. There's a peated malt arrival with cherry stones, a touch of bourbon, vanilla, honey, kind of rye note as well, although not a taste of rye, but something that reminds me of rye, matured rye. Lemon rind and then dried fruit, and then it kind of fades away, becomes drier, and there's a tint of rice vinegar, grappa. And initially there's a kind of odd sharp sour development, which I'm not sure about, but after about 5-10 minutes in the glass it seems to kind of recede and a kind of dried fruitiness comes through. The finish is vanilla, slightly salty, briny salt, mineral, and a sort of slightly harsh wood again, acetic wood, slightly acidic wood note. But interestingly, having tasted these three separately, it is nothing like I would imagine it would be after this length of time. It's almost as if it's created a completely new malt whiskey. It works, but it's a challenge. This isn't easy access malt. The strongest flavoured whiskey that would go into this original blend, single malt blend, would have been the long row, because it's heavily, relatively heavily peated. And that peat is still in there, but it's a kind of different peat. I'm glad I did it. I mean, it's unusual. It's a challenge. It gets you thinking, well, you know, what am I tasting? Why did I get this result when I know the identity of these three components? And I put three together because it's as a golden rule, if you blend in thirds, you tend to get more of a balance. Sure, you can go 50-50, but the chances are the stronger flavour will simply dominate. If you go in thirds, you're essentially you're observing the natural rule of mean ratio of golden ratio as used by Leonardo da Vinci. But that's for another vlog. Marks out of 100, malt marks, because this remains a single malt, I'm going to give this 87 out of 100, which is in fact averages out roughly from the individual marks I gave these whiskies. So it hasn't really become more than the sum of its parts. It's become different from the sum of its parts, and I think that's what's really been interesting about it. And it's not bad at all. Not bad at all. Very tasty, actually. But challenging. I've also noted that there's a kind of burnt toffee note somewhere in the middle of the development that I just can't put my finger on at all. I do not know where that has come from. It certainly hasn't come from the bottle. But my conclusion is that, you know, this is fairly unique. I mean, literally, what do we have here? We have the rarest ever independent bottling of Springbank single malt. It's not even a full bottle. It'll never be in sale. You know, have I got to put a value in this? If I was a marketing department of a whisky company, what price would I put on this? There's not a single bottle out there anything like this. It's got a certain amount of provenance. I'm going to be realistic here. I know I don't have a Lalique or Baccarat crystal decanter to put this into, but it is. It ticks all the boxes of unique provenance, ultra premium, etc., etc. So I think I'll value this at 1 million guineas. That's over £1 million, which makes this the most expensive bottle of whisky in the world ever. And what's more, malt mates, you can do it too. Go for it. Start small. Because I know fine well, I can see you nodding, I can see you smiling. You've got far more than just one bottle of whisky in the house. You've got a few bottles of blends, and you've got a few bottles of malts, and you taste them, turn around, and now is the time to develop your blending skills by starting to match them together, little drops at a time, so you're not wasting your whisky. And when you're ready, when you discover you've got a third of this bottle, a third of another bottle, and perhaps a third of a third bottle, why don't you try putting them together in equal measures and see what you get, in your little specimen bottle before you generate your own unique, either a single malt or a blended malt. Or a blended scotch, if you put a malt in with a blended scotch grain whisky. It is so easy, and the benefit to your experience as a whisky drinker will be significantly enhanced. And then finally, you can talk about it with your whisky mates and your other pals that don't necessarily drink whisky but show an interest. So there you have it. All done and dusted. I'll be back again shortly with some more whisky reviews, and I think we'll have a little hat trick in Japan. Yes, Ralphie.com. I'm Ralphie. I'm happy. I hope you're happy too. See you soon.